They'll run for the first time with J.K. Dobbins. He's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
It's second and eight.
Jackson from the shotgun. He'll find Dobbins out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Third play here, this opening drive, as they're up against a third and five. They're going option play on third down. And he's got his man, Marquise Brown. The 30, 10, and all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, 70 yards. And the Ravens have taken the early lead.
Well, this has been a quick start of offense all season long, finding many different ways to manufacture big plays.
They had a big playoff preview today in the papers, and it was about who would set the tone. Well, they just set the tone right there.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Dolphins take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
Here's the first carry from Matt Breida. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Down at the
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
And it brings up third down.
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. That'll be complete to Breida. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
Matt Breida.
They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Dolphins.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Working out of the gun, Love. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the return here.
I don't know how the fuck that happened, but I'll take it.
That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
That was fucked.
Reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback. He expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. He'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you can see that he thought he'd be in a different
open man. He's got it. Touchdown, Baltimore.
She'll figure it out quick, trust me. Oh, I was using the floor, so you might have to hit up the Wi-Fi. You might have to hook that up with the Wi-Fi, because I have the Ethernet cord.
What are you playing?
My PS5 is right behind the TV. You just can't see it.
Did your family own a PS5?
I was the plug, man.
Yeah.
And
that
decision to bring it out.
That's
how
good. So she got her sleep.
Yes.
Well, like, she got it.
Nice one, nice one. Yeah, that's pretty decent.
Yeah.
You pretty much had to have a plug of some sort if you wanted to get your hands on one. It was crazy this year.
Yeah, a few of my friends.
In the playoffs, not a great combination.
Here's
a throw dropped off to his fullback.
Like, I already have
yeah, mine too. I got a fucking.
It's interesting because when I'm watching.
Well, Warzone's massive, Cold War's massive. They're all fucking big, man.
How do I don't know how to fullbacks.
It's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more fullbacks and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there. And there we saw a completion.
Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player.
Yeah, it'll hook up right to the Wi-Fi. I didn't even see who got hurt. There's another one over here.
On first down, here's Brigham. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No, this is Amber's. I jacked Amber's TV. I would have brought a TV if I had to.
That's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I gotta tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly. And not the three.
And that will be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
And now it's the punter Weil on as he sends this one away. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it?
One for that.
Gives them a chance. They want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing. It puts them in that position.
Yeah. And then there's that little black one somewhere, too. I don't know where it is.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They've got things going.
Yeah, dude, you guys are jamming.
18-0 lead and the football. First and 10. The drive will commence with a run by James O'Gowan. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. A sea of dolphins there that time in on the tackle.
It's okay. Unless you want the speaker, it's up to you. But
your availability, this is an extremely durable kid. Come out of Ohio State, carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to play big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore.
A game of 28 yards there and get him a first down.
Let's all get off the field goal. It's not all the time that the play call should get all the credit. Sometimes I think I'm the quarterback just says, hey, you can't make a play for me. I just need something right here. And the end result there, that's what it's about. The
pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drill, bro. Letting the play develop.
Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see a breakdown of the passers, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away.
Yeah, you can connect it to you can connect it to Alan now.
You have to take the cord. You have to take the cord and then connect it.
Yeah, here.
Is this your cord or ours?
That's yours.
Okay, how long have you been in
that? Like, since I started my game, not very long. I would leave a plug in a little longer.
Yeah, like your Warzone in they call it.
What's up?
They did just that they can't call Warzone because they don't have face. 14. Dolphins nothing. Justin Tucker on this field goal. A 52-yard attempt.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than anyone who turned out kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their history. You'll find that they were big-time athletes. No, they're not. But their kicking was so prevalent that we made them special.
And now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. They'll start on the ground with Brady, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on their own and down. They just have had all the success to get.
Second and 12. To pass, here's Jordan Love. They'll roll him out right. Incomplete on the deep ball. Devontae Parker is the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down.
The scoreboard tells a story for a little bit bleak. And while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close. But the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
An incomplete pass on that last play. And that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Love from the gun.
Oh, that was so lucky.
That's Pierce. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First catch forward in these playoffs. He was held without one last week, but he's got a first down on that effort. Running out of the gun here.
I got like six, bro.
To stand on schedule on offense, the playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Yeah. Oh, that was nice, dude.
Two catches now in his divisional round matchup. The first down.
This guy has definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they're not panicked out there. The way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
They go counter the breather. Long lanes non-existent in this first half. As he's stopping behind the line.
give him much space. The last result's there.
38-yard line, second and 11. Play fake. Here's Lowe. And ahead of traffic, and it's intercepted.
This fucking money.
Picked up the Lowe Badger, Tyron Matthew. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on. One thing is not just maybe the defense is playing bad. Is his goal still well? Is it bad news? What is it? He went even more so about it, Steve. I think it may be rim slip is off. Trying to come up with something.
Getting there, right? 29-yard line. On first and 10, it's Jackson escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. Once the pressure forces his eyes down to see the play, it's time to make a break for it.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson. Running to his right. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs. Able to improvise and get the first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
You can bet it ain't something, baby. I want more. I need to know. Can you make me a promise to always be honest? Fucked up, looking for my heart.
Play action. Like now Jackson. He's gonna fire one deep, middle of the field. Into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Dolphins at the line ready for the next drive. They've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. As a head coach, the offensive coordinator, sometimes they just make a joke with the bad guys.
Man, that would be cool if it worked.
Let's get back on track here. Sometimes that work just fine. I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. They'll throw again. Here's Love on second and 10. They'll set up a screen for Breida. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner. Everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense is able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
And they're left looking at third and 8 after the second down pass play. They went for 2. It's big time by Mike Gesicki. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He's got his first catch here before halftime and goes for a first down. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the midfield stripe, they look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
First down, Miami.
From the gun, Love
sweeps
away to his left.
Oh, my keeper is garbage. It's you. You don't have to play with
it.
No.
Pick of the game. Instead, second down.
I shoot from like 1 meter away.
Even do that.
Second and 10. A very chilly day here, but no snow. And I gotta say, it's gonna be this cold. I want snow. You should see Charlie's face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. And he's gonna be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 15-yard line. In the red zone now.
Ooh, I just got hoed.
Pick of the game. And stand second down.
Second and 10.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Dolphins was on the move, down two straight incompletions, have a look at a 3-10. Going back to Love. Being chased out left.
Oh, good play.
And the Dolphins have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So it's on the halftime of this AFC Divisional Round matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our NBA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC Divisional Round. And we're able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Are you getting whooped by Kaylee, bro?
Yeah.
You stink.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
That's big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down. And find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Love now. Buying time is Love. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down. Well, obviously, you never want to fumble, but if you do, good to be towards the sideline and saves them the possession.
Saves the embarrassment, saves it going down on the play. She has a turnover. But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover. If you give them the football, you gave them the football.
Agree to disagree. Yeah, you played defense. I'll let you go. That's a shot. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
You often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
He'll take this one for about four up to the 40.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They can just pin their ears back and get after him now.
And some space here. 30. Pass the 20. And all the way in for the Miami touchdown. Breedham, 60 yards. And the Dolphins are able to draw a bit closer.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Fire, be ready. Flushed out right. And unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage. Put your heels on the goal line at worst. If they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch it.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Off of play action, he'll look to throw.
Oh.
It's incomplete. Took a shot.
Fuck, he was there.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Jackson. That'll be complete to Dobbins. Room here to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
First down, to the 49-yard line.
From the gun, it's Jackson.
Why did it take so long to get that off?
It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you had. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Jackson now on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. Able to take it down to 42. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
In so many ways, Tony Petrella is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball on the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the team.
A second down completion, got him seven. Now here's third and three. Jackson throwing once more. He's going deep for Brown. It's caught at the 10. He's in to the end zone. Touchdown. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And this offense is running away with this one. He's been a big
You're still winning, like, by
yeah, that's why she doesn't want to play anymore. He stinks. She says, give me a real challenge.
And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result that he opted for the touchback. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you got over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side.
She will,
and so far, just being calm isn't exactly
what they need any spark at this point. Officially, no gain on the play. Second down. Trouble finding open receivers all game, CD. That's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league. And every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Oh, come on, Jeffrey.
Still just a but you gotta make something happen. And if they know that, they're going for it on four.
Alright, let's wrap this thing up.
First and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in for second half blowout material. Dobbins running out of the other
one. I'm losing by
6 yards. And they'll make it second and a quarter, so.
Get 2 3 points.
Make sure you're running jogging with your offensive line. In pregame, get used to the ground shaking and those big behemoths starting to create space for you up front. He's doing a pretty good job of just following those guys through there. Nice explosive run.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now and second down. He works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come down and pick up the first down. But sometimes he just don't want to break tendencies. Stay with your team, stay with your
email. He's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. He's the one that comes home and takes him down for a loss of 9. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. A pickup of 7, but it's still about 12 yards to go on third down. And third quarter here, you've got to believe this is where that 2-1 game can really benefit you. State and bounds are coming back. Get the third down conversion.
conversion.
Look at that, you're winning
for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. First and 10, and they've got 22 ends out there. Jumbo package look.
Oh my god, Ray.
Yeah, right?
I should have busted out playoff money, so.
Yes, you are.
You know the movie Big Daddy, where the kid goes backwards when he plays the card game?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, it kind of is.
The last run got six, now second and four.
See, I'm giving him
the word
right here.
I think, you know, you started doing good when Mike came up.
Now Dobbins. Oh, that was fucking bullshit.
In the backfield, down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Third down and six. They'll go again with Dobbins. And a lot of room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be good because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him.
So it's 3 more points, and that lines this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out as you see.
You have a lot of time about ball control.
The Dolphins have to get on for the next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. And they'll line up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Why is he out of bounds, man?
And he's going to keep it here. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half. No credit yet. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. A swift move and then tackled just on the other side of midfield. 7-yard pick. One thing I think it's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of running after catching the tackle almost on the spot. And he's able to next to plays.
If I miss both of these shots.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
On third down, now he'll let it go deep.
Oh, good one.
It's caught inside the 25. And he is going to hand the ball. We hear them discuss red zone efficiency a lot, CD, and they almost gave that one up in the red zone, but luckily they'll have another shot.
And you and I both know that every offensive coordinator, play caller in the league, they take particular delight in their red zone calls because those are the payoff ones. But you can't call for that if your team doesn't have the ball. Gotta secure it.
And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down. However, let's see what that's about.
I can't wait to get some money, money, nigga, for some.
Honey Badger said, nah. Oh, good play.
Take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins are in for six. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already have it lined up.
That's take you out to play this. I can show you how to let fly into the weekend.
You're gonna eat it, you're gonna